Hi, dear Odooers. In business, there are multiple ways to deal with delivery charges. At Stealthy Wood, we want to charge our customers for the shipment of their products, but we still have to choose between a fixed price or one that's based on rules. And with Odoo, we can also integrate various carriers like FedEx, UPS, and your local postal service to generate delivery options for the customer. This will allow our customers to choose and pay for the specific service they want to use. And they'll see the live cost of the shipment based on the provider they choose when they add new products to their order. More than that, Stealthy Wood can create rules that will be the basis of the shipping costs. Doing this, we could say that heavier shipments will cost more than those which are lighter. We need to update our products to add weight and size so our delivery provider can give our customers an overview of the price they will have to pay for shipping. Though slightly time-consuming at the beginning, it will save us a lot of time in the long run since everything will be automated. So let's see how we can set this up in our database. All right, here I am back on my database. So let's go to the sales application. Then we're going to go to configuration settings. Now, from the settings page, we're going to scroll down to the shipping section and we're going to activate shipping costs. Okay, we're just going to activate this for now, although you do have the option to add some other shipping connectors, which we will talk about in another video. Okay, but for now, let's go ahead and check out our shipping methods that we have. So we can click on this button right here, or we can go to configuration shipping methods. Okay, so I have a couple that are already created. So first of all, we're going to see the name for our delivery method. Then we're also going to have the provider. Now, since I don't have any providers installed, such as UPX, FedEx, and more, I'm just going to see the providers that we offer, which is a price based on rules or a fixed price. Okay, so I'll see that here. I'll be able to see if it's published and if it's related to or published on a specific website or related to a specific company. So for example, if I'm in Belgium, I might want to use the local postal service, so bpost. And if I have bpost here as a delivery method, I'll specify the company. If I'm on Stealthy Wood USA, then I'll use USPS and I'll be sure that I have the Stealthy Wood USA company set on that delivery method. But let's go ahead and check out one of the delivery methods that we have now. So our regular delivery. Okay, I'm going to click on edit. So first of all, we see it's active. Okay, we also see that it is a fixed price. Okay, so it's just your standard fixed price. Okay, on the right, I'm going to be able to add the margin on the rate. So the percentage that we add to the cost. I'm going to say if this delivery method should be free, if the order is above a certain amount, and then we can specify the amount. Of course, if I deselect this, we will not have that amount field. Then I have my delivery product. Okay, we will need to add this to the sales order so that our customers can pay for the shipment. Down below, we're going to be able to add the fixed price. So let's go ahead and say that delivery for all of my items, delivery is $10. Okay, for everyone, for every item, unless the order is more than $1,000. If you're purchasing for more than $1,000 or $1,000 and more, then shipping is free. Okay, just a nice thing that we like to offer. So we're going to go ahead and leave it like that. If I go to destination availability, I can actually say that this shipment method will only be for specific countries or states. I can even add specific zip codes. All right, and then I'm going to be able to add a description as well. I don't need to do that. So let's go ahead and save this the way that it is and let's see it in action on the sales order level. So we're going to go to orders again and create a new sales order. So let's add our customer, Azure Interior, one of our best customers. And then we're going to add a product. Okay, so let's go ahead and add a cabinet with doors. So we see the unit price is 14, total is 1610, so well below $1,000. All right, and then we're going to add the shipping. Okay, so I'm just going to choose delivery. And I see that the cost is $10. Okay, that's the fixed price that we added. And I'm going to click on add. Okay, it's added to the total, it has its own tax, everything looks good. Now, of course, I can always manually edit the line on the sales order. So let's say for this particular customer, it's $15. I can edit that here, I can confirm the sales order this way, but you're gonna see that the line is orange. That means that the system recognizes that it isn't the price it should be based on the rules we set up. So what I can do is click on update shipping cost if that was a mistake. And then I see that the cost should be $10. I can click on update and the line will be corrected. Now let's see what happens if I change the price for this item. So let's say that this item is actually $1,500. Okay, I see that the line turns orange again. And that's because Odoo knows that if the total is above $1,000, then the shipment should be free and not $10 anymore. So we click on update shipping cost. And we do see that the fixed price is $10, but that the shipping is free since the order amount exceeds $1,000. And then we can click on update and the change is applied. Okay, so that was super fast and super easy to do, but let's do something slightly more complicated. Let's make a shipping method based on rules. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to my shipping methods, my regular delivery. I'm gonna click on edit and say that this is based on rules. Okay, we see that we don't have just a field where we can add the fixed price, but now we can add some rules. So let's go ahead and add a line. So first of all, we need to specify a condition. So I'm going to make this based on weight, but you can also choose volume, weight times volume, price, and quantity. Okay, so you have a lot of options here. But I'm going to say if the weight is more than one, so 1 kilo or 1 pound, depending on how you have your database set up. If the weight is more than one, the delivery cost is going to be 100. Then we can save and close. I'm going to add a second rule saying if the weight is less than or equal to one, the delivery cost is going to be 50, and save and close. Now, of course, you can add as many rules as you would like. I can also add some rules based on another condition here as well, but I'm not going to, but you should note that the sequence does matter. Okay, you can drag and drop these so that whichever rule applies first based on the sales order, that will be the first one on the list, will be the first that applies. Okay, so Odoo will simply go down the list and whichever rule first applies, that will be the one that is on the sales order. Okay, so let's go ahead and save this. And again, see it in action. So we're gonna create a new sales order. Okay, let's take our client again as your interior. And of course, since this is based on weight, I really need to be sure that I have a weight set on my product, okay, which I do. All right, I have a weight set on my pedal bin, and I'm going to show you that right now. So I'm going to open up the product template. I'm going to go to the inventory tab, and we see the weight right here under the logistics section. Okay, this is a super light pedal bin. Let's go ahead and save, and we're going to add the shipping, okay? So we're going to choose delivery, and we see that the cost is $50 because the weight is less than 1 kilo. Okay, so we can add that. All right, but what happens if we change the weight? Okay, so we need to go back to the inventory tab. Let's add a weight that's a bit more reasonable for a pedal bin. So let's say 5 kilos. We're going to save, and when I click on update shipping cost, I'm going to see that the cost is now 100. Okay, so I see that my rules are applying properly, and then we can update. All right, so you can see that setting up basic delivery rules, either on a fixed price or on different rules, it's super easy with Odoo. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.